the prophet, the psychic, coming back at you again with another video. All right. People, you know, this is very interesting, people. I was looking at the some of the betting, the sports betting, gambling sites. And because, see, one thing about that, those sports, those gambling sites that's betting on tennis, they know tennis because they're dealing with money. Actually, sometimes they can call it better than the tennis experts that we listen to on TV. Well, that y'all listen to, because y'all know I don't hardly listen to them. But, but listen, check this out. People, Vegas... Yes, Vegas people, they giving Serena Williams a better chances of winning the French Open than I am. Now Vegas, they ain't saying Serena is not the top favorite, of course. But people, listen, they got something like this. They got Simona Halep number one, Spitzelina number two. They got Serena Williams on most of the sites, it's like number 4 or 5. Dave, and some of the sites got Serena favored over Ostapenko. And I don't think Serena probably can't beat Ostapenko in the French Open. I mean, we never know. Like I said before, we got to see Serena. Let's see what she looked like the first round. And I said, I did my preview the other day. I said, Serena probably will not win. And she, if she could just make it to the quarterfinals of the French Open, that would be a good showing for her. Okay? And I think it's going to be hard for Serena to beat a Muguruza or Ostapenko. But people, listen, check this out. Kvitova, and I'm going to talk about her more. People, she got like the best record on clay this season. I think it's 13-2 or something like that. People, she's like number 9 on most of the sites. So I don't think, I'm going to be honest about it. And Kvitova just won the Rome. And she knows she's a 2-time champion, though. I'm saying right now she's playing some of the best tennis on clay. Right now, she's like number 9 on some of the sites. So they got Serena favored over Kvitova, and I would totally disagree with that. So this is what I asked the question. Now, people, let me say something. Vegas is not stupid, okay? When it comes to like the betting, and they know what they're doing, and you know how they say Vegas never loses. Now Vegas, listen, Vegas could lose like on Serena, but they'll get their money overall. I know how that gambling stuff works. But people, so I was asking a question though: why is Serena Williams? Why do they have Serena Williams? Why are they giving Serena? Why do they have her like out of 10 women? Like I told y'all, there's almost 10 to 15 women that has a good chance of winning the French Open. This is the most wide open women's French Open I've ever seen, people. Yeah, the people, look, hey, you can look at, there's women that's number 13. There's women that's number 18. What's her name? Burton's. She's number 18 in the world. She's got one of the best records on clay this season. Okay, now somebody may say, well, she got to step up at the big moment. But still, Burton's could up... Listen, she could easily upset a Simona Halep or somebody like that. Okay, but I ask the question, why is Vegas and all these gambling sites got Serena Williams so high? So now I saw that the other day, and I wasn't going to come back and make another video. I just said, okay, Vegas, and they don't know that Serena's recovering, but they do know that. But this is what made me, there was something else that made me review this again. I don't know. Am I going to say Serena's going to go farther than the quarterfinals? Maybe not. But I want to review this again, though, just to see why, and I know why. I know why Vegas and all these gambling sites that know what they're doing, because they're dealing with money. They're dealing with money. Why are they giving Serena even a better chance than the tennis prophet is? Okay, people, check this out. I actually didn't know this right here. That was an interesting stat. I went to the WTA site just to look at who do they have as the top favorites on clay. The top women favorites, of course. And one thing that they taking laid out the career winning percentage on clay for like the top 10 women that they chose, and Serena was one of them. And they asked her, see, even them, they got Serena like number 4. So, but listen, Serena's career winning percentage on clay, people, is 83%. Now, people, you may, so let me give people that 83% is really good. Now, people, y'all remember I told y'all that Federer has a 76% winning percentage on clay. That's better than even team. And Nadal got like a 96%, almost 97%. But Serena got a 83% winning percentage on clay. And to give y'all some idea, most of the women got like a 65. The average of the top women on clay, their career's like 65%, around that 60 to 65. So Vegas, see, now you may be saying, okay, Magic Man, well, why do you think, what I'm trying to do right now, I'm trying to meet Vegas somewhere. Why is Vegas giving Serena a better chance than even a tennis prophet? But people, check this out now. Here's what's funny. And I'm going to meet Vegas halfway. The reason why Vegas is doing it is Vegas is looking at that number. They know Serena is recovering. And they know sort of what Serena is. Serena, okay, she got blasted by Naomi Osaka in the Miami first round. Serena played okay, but Naomi was at a super level. That was on the hard court. But so now people, now this is where I'm finna meet Vegas in the center. Okay, y'all remember that I told y'all just last week, I made a lot of videos saying that a lot of players, including Federer, who plays well on clay, but he doesn't play the same on clay. He's not as efficient on clay as he is on grass and on the fast court. So Vegas is counting on this. They're saying that if Serena Williams meet Naomi Osaka on clay, it won't be the same as on the hard court. She can't hit as many winners on Serena Williams as she hit at the Miami Open. And I agree with Vegas 1,000%. Vegas is saying that 83% that Serena has, that 83 winning percentage, career winning percentage that Serena Williams has on clay, even if you drop it to 65%. So I know what Vegas is doing. They say that Serena could still make a good showing. She may not win, but she may be able to beat a Naomi Osaka on clay. And y'all saw Naomi Osaka got beat 6-0, 6-1 on clay when she played Serena Williams. I mean, when she played Simona Halep just the other week. So Vegas is actually taking my theory that maybe Serena Williams can have a better showing on clay. And now forget that most players don't play as well on clay as they play on other surfaces. People, remember I told y'all I disagreed. I think Serena should have played Madrid and Rome like the Djokovic did, because on clay is the people can't hit as fast, so you have a chance to work on your game and you have a chance to stay in the points longer. So maybe Vegas knows that. That's why Vegas is giving Serena Williams a chance of going maybe to the semis or something, okay? So I just wanted to review that. Now, have I changed my mind? I said that I think Serena Williams, I think she could make it to the quarters, but not farther than that. You know what? I still stay with that, but I understand why I just wanted to explain. I mean, could Serena Williams make it to the semis? Yes, but I think by the quarters, man. See, here's another thing. The reason why I think it's going to be tough for Serena to get past the quarters, man, there is so many women. I told y'all, there's like 15 women that could win. They could win the French Open, people. People, Vegas and these gamblers say they got like Kvitova, number 9. But Kvitova could easily upset I wouldn't even call it an upset. Man, if she faced Simona Halep, I may take Kvitova. I mean, she's already won two majors. Simona Halep hasn't even won a major. Kvitova got a better record than Simona Halep. I think Simona Halep is 9-3. Kvitova is like 11-2, 11-3, something like that. She got just as good a better record than Simona Halep right now on clay. Kvitova just won the Madrid, right? I think it was Madrid she won, not the wrong, the Madrid. So that wouldn't even be an upset if Kvitova can beat Simona Halep. So yeah, this is going to be, so I think, see, that's why, let me give it to the point. I don't want to get on Kvitova right now. That's another video. I just want to say that the reason why, you may say, well, why don't you, after you made this argument why Vegas is giving Serena a better chance than I am, you may say, well, why won't I change my mind that Serena won't go past the quarters? Because of what I just said, like Kvitova. I think she going to have a hard time beating Kvitova, Bertens, Kasatkina. I think it's going to be tough to beat them. But what I'm saying, making it to the quarters is great, I think, as far as Serena recovering. Okay, people, I just want to bring that out again and review the Serena preview, okay? But I still stick with that Serena. I don't think she'll make it past the quarters, though. I'd be a little surprised if she made it past the quarters. Okay, people, tennis preacher, prophet, psychic, signing off. Have a good one.
Dance, 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 dance. Ooh, yeah, you can dance too. That's the way his name is.